Hello everyone, welcome to Unlock Maths. Today we have to find inverse Laplace transform of this given function by using convolution theorem. So first here we have to write down the statement of convolution theorem. This theorem states that if we know the inverse Laplace transform of f of s and g of s, then inverse Laplace transform of their product can be found by using this integral, right? So we have to apply convolution theorem for finding inverse Laplace transform of this given function. So here we have to write down this given function as a f of s. This is here we have s square upon s square minus a square its square, right? And we have write down this is capital F of s. And here we have to find this is L inverse of this given function F of s. That means here we have to find L inverse of this s square minus a square its square, right? Now for applying convolution theorem, what we have to do? Yes, we have to write down this given function in two functions such that we can find their inverse Laplace easily. So we can write this f of s as a, this is s upon s square minus a square. This is into s upon s square minus a square, right? So this is first function and this one is second. So we can write this is as a f of s into g of s. So here we have write down f of s as a, this is s upon s square minus a square. And next function, this g of s, this is s upon s square minus a square. Now we can find L inverse of this two function easily here. Yes, we can check that this is standard formula, right? And we know its inverse Laplace transform, this is cos of h a t. Same here, L inverse of g of s, this is L inverse of s upon s square minus a square. This is same cos of h a t, right? We got L inverse of g of s, this is g of t, and L inverse of f of s, this is f of t, right? Yes, here we have find f of t and g of t. That means here we have find L inverse of these two functions. Now we can find L inverse of their product by using this integral. So here we have to write down from this f of t and g of t, we have to find f of u and g of t minus u so that we can apply this given integral. So here we want f of u and this g of t minus u. So how to find f of u? We have to replace this is t by u. So here we have this is cos of h a u. And same here, what we have to do? We have to replace this is t by t minus u. So here we have cos of h a t minus u, right? So we have find f of u and g of t minus u. Now we can write down this both value in given integral. So here we have L inverse of this f of s into g of s. This is integral within limit 0 to t. This is f of u into g of t minus u. This integral is with respect to u. So we have to put down this both value here. So integral within limit 0 to t cos of h a u into this cos of h a t minus u, right? Again, we can write this is as a, yes, we can simplify this is cos of h, this is a t minus a u, right? Now we can check that we have this is product of hyperbolic function, right? And we have to evaluate this integral. So for evaluation, what we have to do, we have to convert this product into addition or subtraction so that we can find their integral easily. So here we have this identity. This is here we have cos of hx into cos of hy. This is hyperbolic identity. We know this is here. This is cos of h x plus y plus cos of h x minus y, right? So by using this, we have cos of h a u into cos of h a t minus a u. This is, yes, we have to apply, this is here. So here we have cos of h a u plus this is a t minus a u plus cos of h. Now we want subtraction. So a u minus this is a t minus a u, right? Yes, we have treated this is as a x and this is as a y. Okay, now on simplification, this is 1 by 2. Yes, this AU get cancelled. So here we have cos of h AT plus this is cos of h AU. This minus get inside. So here we have minus AT plus AU. Yes. So here we have, this is cos of h a t plus cos of h. Now here we have, this is twice a u minus a t, right? Yes, now we have write down this product into this addition. So we have to put down this value in this given integral. So here we have, now we have to evaluate this integral here. We have this 1 by 2 common. So yes, here we can do the separation here. Cos of h a t. Same here, this integral of cos of h twice a u minus a t. Right. Now this is 1 by 2 common to both integral. This integral is with respect to u. So cos of h a t, this is constant. And integral of this du, this is u, right? And this integral is within limit 0 to t. Yes. And same here. Integral of this hyperbolic cos, this is here we have sine h, right? Sine h of twice a u minus a t. Since this integral is with respect to u, so upon here we have this twice a, and this is within limit 0 to t. Now yes, we have to note down that here we have hyperbolic cos, and hyperbolic cos integral, this is sine, hyperbolic sine, right? We know how we got this is here. Yes, we know what is the value of cos of hx and sine of hx, right? So we have find integral of both. Now we have to put down the limit. So cos of hat, this is as it is, and this is t minus 0, right? Plus this 1 upon twice a, this is constant. And here we have to put down limit in u, right? Since this integral is with respect to u. So here we have sine h, this is twice a t minus a t. This is for upper limit, and for lower limit, this minus of sine, this is twice a, at u we have to put 0, and this a t as it is, right? So here we have, this is cos of h a t into t plus 1 upon twice a, this is as it is, and this is sine of h twice 80 minus 80. Here we have 80, this minus, here we have sine of minus 80, since this is 0, right? Yes. Now, again we have to do the simplification. And this is, yes, we know that sine of minus theta is equals to minus of sine theta, right? So, this minus get outside and here we have sine of 80, yes. This is, here we have hyperbolic sine, yes, sine of h 80. So, here we have L inverse of f of s and g of s, this is 1 by 2 t into cos of h 80 plus 1 upon twice a. Now this sine h 80 plus sine h 80, this is 2 times sine h 80, right? Yes. Now this 2 to get cancelled. Again. Right. If you want, we can further simplify. We can take this 1 upon a outside. So, here we have 1 upon twice a and remaining. Yes, now a will get to this. So, here we have 80 into cos of h 80 plus sine of h 80. And this is the required inverse Laplace transform of this given function. So yes, that's it for now. See you in the next video. Thank you. Keep watching.